It had been 3 years since Cruella de Vil, that dog-napping demon, that fur-crazy fiend, that wild-haired witch, was thrown in prison for stealing 99 darling Dalmatian puppies and trying to turn them into a spotted fur coat. You would think that a wicked woman like Cruella was beyond hope, that you would never see the evil of her wicked ways and be set free. Think again. Cruella's lawyer had a plan. He paid a visit to Dr. Pavlov, a scientist who had developed a way to tame even the most savage beasts and make them as gentle as could be.
I have patented a humane cocktail of electric shock treatment, aversion therapy, hypnosis, drugs, and plenty of green vegetables.
Dr. Pavlov demonstrated how well his therapy worked on the animals in his laboratory. He showed the lawyer a cat sitting calmly while a yellow canary perched on its head and a fox passively watching a goose take a bath. Then he set out to cure Cruella. And before long, she and her lawyer were back in court trying to convince the judge that she had changed for good.
Cruella de Vil, I am releasing you into the custody of the probation office. You will perform 500 hours of community service. Mr. Tort, your client is, I believe, a wealthy woman.
After my exorbitant fees, my lord, her assets stand at a mere £8 million.
Then you will be bound over to keep the peace to the sum of £8 million. If forfeited, the money will be donated forthwith and entire to the dogs' homes of the borough of Westminster, which means if you repeat the offense, your entire fortune will go to the dogs.
And so, just like that, Cruella de Vil was released from prison. Outside the prison, Cruella's faithful servant, Alonso, waited for her.
Oh, Miss Deville, I've waited for this day. I hope it's not too presumptuous, but I brought you a gift.
Oh, Alonso, how considerate.
Alonso offered Cruella a wrapped box. Cruella pulled on the ribbon, the top of the box flew off, and a tiny, trembling, hairless dog popped out, gasping.
I think I'll call him Fluffy.
He's smiling at me. Oh, what a sweet voice.
Wrong side, Alonso. Come, Fluffy. Mummy will drive.
And snatching the keys from Alonso, Cruella hopped into her huge car with Fluffy and sped off. Meanwhile, Dr. Pavlov was thrilled with his success in calming the cold-hearted Cruella. But Dr. Pavlov's assistant was too busy watching television to listen to the doctor's bragging. Just then, London's famous clock tower, Big Ben, began bonging from the overly loud television. And a terrible racket erupted from the doctor's laboratory. The goose flapped out in distress, and Dr. Pavlov slammed the door before the fox could follow her. Then the cat strolled out, looking satisfied. A few yellow feathers drifting in the air behind her. Big Ben's bells had apparently undone all of Dr. Pavlov's hard work.
Turn down the television! Quick!
A unique sound pattern. Very loud.
That were Big Ben on the telly.
Yes. It must have jolted their brainwaves back into... This mustn't get out. Do you hear me? It never happened.
Dr. Pavlov wasn't the only one disturbed by Big Ben. Across town, Chloe Simon had to shut her office window to be heard over the huge clock, which was only about 100 feet away. Chloe was a probation officer, which means she worked with people who have just been released from prison. She was meeting with one of her clients, a young man named Ewan. Ewan was telling Chloe about his new job.
Dog shelter suits me. I think I found myself.
Chloe looked over Ewan's file. She saw that the dog shelter wasn't paying him.
Yeah, well, we're a bit tight on funds at the moment.
Ewan, I won't say it again. No pay stub, No probation.
Just then, Chloe's boss, Agnes, walked in. Ewan got up to leave.
Thanks, miss.
Next week, then. You do put the fear of God into them, Chloe, which is why I've chosen you to...
Suddenly, the phone rang. Chloe grabbed for it, sending file folders flying.
Hello? Stay there. Keep breathing, and I'll be there in a second.
Chloe needed to get home fast. She snatched up her purse and briefcase. As she tore out of the office, Agnes handed her a new file.
Chloe! Hey! You've forgotten this.
What the...
Meanwhile, Ewan was headed back to work at the Second Chance dog shelter. He arrived in time to see his boss, Kevin Shepherd, playing with several of the dogs while a talking parrot named Waddlesworth looked on. Waddlesworth noticed that Ewan was carrying a huge bag of dog food.
Come on, boys! It's grab time!
All the dogs rushed to grab their bowls. Waddlesworth also grabbed a bowl and barked for food. Waddlesworth had been living at the dog shelter so long, he believed he was a dog too. The bird ate his food on the ground with the rest of the dogs.
Save some for tomorrow. I don't know where our next meal's coming from.
My mum always said, when the heart hopes, hope comes knocking.
Just then, there was a knock at the door.
Hope comes knocking.
Ewan opened the door and discovered Mr. Button, the owner of the shelter's building.
Evicted?
But he wasn't bringing hope.
You said
he was bringing an eviction notice.
You can't turn all these dogs loose in this city. Give us another chance.
I'm not the one running a charity here.
Mr. Button left in a huff. By that time, Cruella had arrived at her house. She swept into her huge mansion holding Fluffy. Alonzo watched as she climbed the stairs and disappeared into her bedroom. There was a moment of silence, then...
Ah! Fire! It's everywhere! Lock them away! Bury them beyond sight and memory!
I will. Your Siberian boat-type boots?
Yes, yes!
And the Mount Panda jacket?
Everything! No!
It's just chicken.
Alonzo gathered up all the fur clothing Cruella owned and carried it off to a secret room. The room was hidden behind a portrait of a long-dead Deville. Cruella followed Alonzo in with her eyes closed.
And this?
It was Cruella's old drawing of the Dalmatian fur coat.
Seal the room! Quickly!
And Alonzo boarded up the secret room. Meanwhile, Chloe, our probation officer, had made it home to her beloved pet dogs, Dipstick and Dotty, who happened to be Dalmatians. Dotty was about to give birth, and the clever Dipstick had completed most of the preparations before Chloe even got there. Chloe and Dipstick stayed up all night and helped Dotty as she delivered three beautiful puppies. The last one arrived just before dawn. At last, Chloe left Dotty's side and collapsed into an armchair, exhausted. Dipstick came over to sit with her. But when he saw the morning newspaper on a nearby footstool, he went crazy.
Shh, Dipstick. The puppies. Be quiet.
Chloe picked up the paper. Cruella de Vil's picture was on the front page.
I do not believe it.
How could they release that?
Oh, I pity the poor probation officer that has to look.
Chloe realized that the newspaper was lying on top of one of the files she'd brought home. The file had Cruella's name on it. Chloe was to be Cruella's probation officer.
No. No, it's not possible. Well, I refuse. I'm not doing it. No way.
Dipstick thought otherwise. He put his paw on Chloe's arm, pleadingly.
You remember her, don't you? You remember what she almost did to you. Dipstick... Okay. I'll do it for you. And for the family.
The next day, Cruella showed up at Chloe's office for her first appointment.
Miss Deville.
Yes.
5 minutes late. That's a bad start. I'm your probation officer, Chloe Simon.
Yes, of course you are. And we're going to be such friends.
friends.
You are going to help me be a useful member of society, aren't you?
Find me a little niche somewhere?
Could you manage something with puppy dogs?
I see you more as a coal miner. Or something in the sewers, perhaps.
Oh, I see.
But Cruella was determined to work with dogs. Later that day, she showed up at the Second Chance Dog Shelter with a line of reporters following her. Kevin and Ewan were amazed to see the most famous dog hater in London at their shelter.
Cruella de Vil.
Please, please, call me Ella. This place and I were made for each other. Is it yours?
No, it's mine. And he...
Alonso, buy the dump. And give him a little extra for a tie.
When Chloe saw news of Cruella buying the shelter on TV, she hopped on her motor scooter and drove there to put an end to the monkey business. Kevin was outside.
Are you Kevin Shepherd?
Kevin found Chloe very beautiful.
Yes, yes, I'm Kevin.
And you call yourself a dog lover. I'm Chloe Simon, Cruella de Vil's probation officer.
Oh!
You know, I don't think I trust anyone who knowingly puts Cruella de Vil anywhere near dogs.
Well, yes, but she's changed.
Chloe did not believe him. Kevin took her into the shelter. Workmen were busily renovating the place, courtesy of Cruella. Kevin brought Chloe to a back room where Cruella was grooming a very reluctant sheepdog.
Hair must be a statement, a reflection of our inner life. Colour is important, of course, but texture is vital.
Chloe was certainly surprised, but she still couldn't believe that Cruella was truly transformed. Over the next several weeks, Cruella's canine collaborations were front page news. Pictures of Cruella and various pooches appeared on covers of the top magazines. Stories of Cruella manning adopt-a-pet booths and awarding prizes at dog shows ran on television. The Second Chance Dog Shelter was transformed from a rundown mess into a fabulous Moroccan-style palace, while more and more donations poured in every day. Chloe kept close tabs on Cruella, but she also watched with joy as the puppies, Domino, Little Dipper, and Oddball, the only girl, grew. Oddball had earned her name because she was all white. The poor puppy had not developed spots, and she was not happy about it. One day, Chloe decided to take the whole family to work. Chloe's boss, Agnes, was delighted to have the dogs for company. She led them into her office.
Come along, dearies. Come with Aunt Agnes. It's probably just as well with Miss Deville coming in.
Cruella?
Yes, she asked to change her appointment. I thought you knew. Come on, Oddball.
Agnes began playing a computer game with Dotty and Dipstick, while Domino and Little Dipper watched. Poor little Oddball was not interested. She could only focus on the fact that her parents and brothers all had spots, and she didn't. Oddball noticed a repairman working on the copier machine across the hall. As he worked, he rubbed black copier ink on his pants. The repairman was giving himself spots. Without anyone noticing, she bounded across the hallway and leapt up onto the copier. She rolled around on some ink-stained paper until her own body was covered with black spots. Success! Domino and Little Dipper looked up to see what their sister was so excited about. Imagine their surprise as they watched the repairman lift up the copier lid without looking and flip Oddball right out the open window. Luckily for Oddball, there was a ledge and a gutter outside the window. So instead of falling five stories, Oddball landed in the gutter. But as she did, her section of gutter came loose and swung away from the wall. Domino and Little Dipper dashed to their sister's rescue, leaving Agnes and the adult Dalmatians engrossed in their computer game.
Good shot, Dipstick.
Meanwhile, Cruella had arrived and was meeting with Chloe.
I have so much to atone for.
Chloe was actually starting to wonder if Cruella hadn't changed after all. Just then, Little Dipper appeared on the ledge outside the window. Cruella saw the puppy first. She stood up and pointed just as Big Ben started to chime.
I'm seeing spots.
Chloe turned to look and saw Oddball in the broken gutter swinging away from the building as Domino and Little Dipper stood on the ledge trying to rescue her. Chloe threw open the window and jumped out onto the ledge. With the window open, Big Ben was deafening. Cruella reeled back as if she'd been hit between the eyes. Big Ben was reversing Cruella's cure. Agnes, Dipstick and Dotty came running in.
The puppies! Oh! Grab my legs! Grab my legs! What?
With Agnes holding onto her legs, Chloe was able to hang out of the window far enough to pull Little Dipper and Domino back inside. Then she plucked Oddball off the broken gutter and tossed her inside as well. Oddball flew right into Cruella, knocking her to the floor. Cruella clutched Oddball to her chest, relishing the feel of the puppy fur. Dipstick spotted Cruella. Cruella eyed the Dalmatian curiously. She seemed to recognize him.
I remember you. As a puppy.
A vivid memory of dozens of Dalmatian puppies flooded through Cruella's brain.
Why don't I come back later? I'm feeling a little chilly.
Cruella staggered out of the door as Chloe, Agnes, and the dogs watched her go. She hugged the hallway wall, trying to recover. She opened her eyes and saw the copier, repairman. He had spots. She reeled away down the hall, out of the building and onto the street. She rushed for the comfort of her nearby car, where Alonzo waited. Cruella looked up at him, then covered her eyes. Alonzo had spots. So had the car. Everywhere, spots. Spotted cars, spotted buses, spotted buildings. Clearly, something was very wrong.
Wouldn't you be more comfortable in the car? Ella?
Not Ella. Ella's gone. And Cruella's back!
Back at her mansion, Cruella set Alonzo to work immediately unboarding the secret room behind the portrait of the long-dead Deville. Then she threw open the door, spread her arms wide, and stood before the huge pile of furs.
Oh, Mummy's home, and I'll never leave you again! Oh, yes! Oh.
Cruella buried her face in fur, inhaling, caressing. And yet, something was not quite right.
Why do I feel incomplete? What could be missing from my life? Cruella de Vil, who has it all? The softest, the rarest, the whitest, the blackest, the stripiest, the spottiest. Of course. Where is it? Where? Where is it?
Cruella snatched up her old drawing of the Dalmatian coat.
My Dalmatian.
Puppy coat. The coat of dreams. The ultimate fur coat that was denied me by the canine cabal, for which I have lost 3 years of my life! Alonzo, we are going to make them pay.
Oh, yes, how much?
Dipstick, she called him.
Oh, it's fiendish justice. He escaped me, but I shall wreak my vengeance on the next generation.
Sounds wonderful.
Alonzo, I need you. I need you. I'm yours.
Manage yourself with a tall to large sack and rubber soled shoes. Meanwhile, I need a farrier.
And I know just where to find him.
Jean-Pierre Lepelt was a farrier and an old friend of Cruella's. She found him at a fashion show he was having to exhibit his new line of fur clothing. Cruella put on a heavily veiled hat so no one would recognize her, and joined the crowd watching Lepelt's models parade down the runway in nothing but fur. Fur bikinis, fur pajamas, fur sunglasses, fur shoes. After the show, Cruella made her way backstage and into Lepelt's dressing room. She took off her hat and veil, revealing herself.
Cruella de Vil, my idol, my inspiration, and my soul.
Jean-Pierre, you've come such a long way from poaching weasels.
And you're out of prison at last.
Yes, terrible experience, prison. The cut of the fabric.
The door burst open, and Alonso entered. He'd nabbed his first puppy.
You shouldn't have brought them in here, you idiot!
What is this?
Your salvation, Jean-Pierre. Monsieur Lepelt has clearly run out of ideas. I propose an alliance between Monsieur Lepelt and the House of Deville.
You have an idea in the bag.
Jean-Pierre, together, you and I will make a coat so bad that we'll rip the veils off the eyes of fashion and write our names in the pantheon of stars.
The coats? From poopies.
Ah, not just any poopies. Poopies with...
Cruella reached into Alonso's bag and pulled out a Dalmatian puppy.
Spots.
That weekend, Chloe took her Dalmatians to see a puppet show in the park. As she approached the ticket booth, she ran into Kevin from the dog shelter with some of his animal pals. Kevin was delighted to see the beautiful Chloe. He introduced his friends.
This is Digger, Chomp, and Drooler, Bottlesworth, Meat.
The two adults and the nine animals made their way into the puppet theatre, found their seats, and began enjoying the show. Oddball quickly noticed that one of the puppets was wearing a polka-dotted sweater. Chloe became concerned.
Oddball's obsessed with S-P-O-T-S.
Spots!
Oddball rushed onto the stage.
Oddball!
Too late, Oddball snatched the polka-dotted puppet from the puppeteer's hand and took off with it through the audience. Kevin, Chloe, and the dogs jumped up and chased after her through the park. Oddball tumbled down a walkway and crashed into a man selling balloons. Poor little Oddball got tangled in the balloon strings, and before anyone could grab her, she rose up into the air.
Don't worry, I'll get her.
Without a moment to lose, Kevin raced after the balloons. He climbed onto the top of the puppet house, and just as Oddball and the balloons were drifting by, Kevin jumped off the roof and grabbed the strings. Oddball was saved. Kevin slid down a slide and was immediately overwhelmed by Chloe and the dogs.
Oh, Kevin, I don't know how to thank you.
Waddlesworth had an idea.
How about dinner?
Sorry?
I was inviting you to dinner.
Dinner would be nice.
A few nights later, Cruella and Lepelt were in the secret room studying the drawing of the Dalmatian coat.
40 Dalmatian puppies shipped off to Paris.
To his shop.
Not enough.
We need 102. This time, I want a hooded spotted puppy coat.
A hooded spotted puppy coat?
Oh, stop whining! I'm a perfectly good idiot to take the fall.
That same night, Kevin showed up at Chloe's flat for a date. But Kevin didn't come alone. He brought Digger, Drooler, Chomp, and Waddlesworth with him. Dipstick answered the door for them. The dogs were delighted to see each other again. Kevin looked around for Chloe.
Hello.
I'll be right out, Kevin.
Waddlesworth had brought a gift for Oddball. Dotty helped Oddball open the box, and Oddball pulled out the spotted sweater from the puppet show. Chloe emerged from the bedroom dressed for the date.
Oh, Kevin, thank you. It's brilliant.
Later, at the restaurant, the subject of Cruella naturally came up.
Did you know that if she ever goes back to dog napping, that all her millions would go straight into the dogs' homes of the borough of Westminster?
Yes, I did, because it's in her file. But how did you know that?
Well, she told me. And did you know that Second Chance is the only dog shelter in the borough?
You're joking.
Chloe and Kevin were very happy together. By the time they got back to Chloe's apartment, all the dogs were asleep.
I had a great time.
So did I.
Look, I know you don't believe in second chances, but
Do you believe in second dates?
I do, actually.
Good. Great. Good night.
Kevin left with Digger, Drooler, Chomp, and Wattlesworth. The next morning, Kevin was at work at the Second Chance Dog Shelter when the phone rang.
Puppies. Oh, puppies. We'll pick them up right away, monsieur.
Bye.
Box of abandoned puppies, just round the corner.
Abandoned, no more.
Kevin wrote down the address and Ewan left to pick up the puppies. Just then, a police car pulled up. Two officers approached the door.
Oh, blimey, the coppers!
How can I help you, officer?
A warrant to search the premises.
Kevin was shocked, but he let the officers in. A few minutes later, Cruella's car pulled up to the dog shelter, just as Chloe arrived on her motor scooter. Chloe had received a mysterious call about poopies that morning as well. Chloe rushed into the shelter with Cruella following. The officers were questioning Kevin about some missing Dalmatian puppies. Chloe immediately suspected Cruella.
No, he's not the one. She is. Why suspect Kevin?
Caught him red-handed, and he's got a record for dog napping.
Just then, Ewan entered carrying a cardboard box.
Whatever it is, I didn't do it.
No, I sent Ewan to pick up those.
One of the officers pulled a Dalmatian puppy from the box.
This is crazy. Why would I steal Dalmatians?
Hmm?
What possible motive could I have to...
The judge's order.
Oh, Kevin, how could you? All this for money?
What?
Just like you said at the restaurant.
If I'm caught stealing puppies, my entire fortune goes to him. Would that be a motive?
Kevin was stunned. Digger, Drooler, Chomp and Wattlesworth refused to be separated from him, so the police loaded them all into the paddy wagon. Cruella distracted everyone, so they didn't notice Alonzo secretly rounding up the Dalmatian puppies and throwing them into the trunk of Cruella's car. The paddy wagon drove off. Chloe approached Cruella.
I'm sorry, Mr. Ville. I had no idea that Kevin was ill. That I let myself trust him.
Oh, this is all so dreadful. You need distraction, darling. I'm having a few friends round for dinner tonight with their dogs. Why don't you and yours join us? Adults only, of course. Oh, do come. Remember, darling, we have the doggies to live for.
So that night, Chloe took Dipstick to Cruella's house. The DeVille mansion was brightly lit as all the richest of London's aristocrats arrived with their dogs for a really big party. Cruella saw Chloe and Dipstick arrive.
Chloe, darling! Dipstick! How kind of you to come. Oh, we're not still holding a grudge, are we?
Dipstick, be polite.
I'm so pleased you're here, darling. Now, tell me, your little spotted puppies are snug and safe at home?
Yes, they're with Dotty.
Oh, with Mummy?
Yes.
How dear.
Cruella grinned evilly. Little did Chloe know that Cruella had invited her so the puppies would be left home alone. Cruella was intent on getting Chloe's puppies for the hood of her Dalmatian coat. Alonzo had to help with the party, so LePelt was already on his way over to Chloe's flat to steal them. When LePelt arrived at Chloe's, the dogs were asleep. Oddball wore her spotted sweater. LePelt crept quietly in through the bathroom window, but not quietly enough. Halfway in, he slipped and tumbled into the toilet. Dotty snapped awake. LePelt pulled himself out of the toilet and snuck into the living room, where he found the basket of puppies.
Bonsoir, my little ones. I am the great LePelt, and you are, how do you say, dog meat.
LePelt froze and turned to see Dotty.
Oh, nice. Nice.
Yeah! Domino and Little Dipper raced for the front door, and Oddball ran to the window to sound the alarm. In a nearby flat, a bloodhound puppy heard Oddball's cry for help and began to howl. The howl was heard in turn by some Great Dane puppies next door, and they began barking. And so Oddball's frantic message was sent from one dog to another out across the darkening streets and back alleys of London. Back at the DeVille mansion, Cruella's party was becoming very interesting. She had the people seated on one side of the long dining room table and the dogs on the other.
Tonight, our dogs join us at table so we can show our appreciation to a magnificent species. My past has been riddled with mistakes. I pray someday to be forgiven. But tonight, I will begin to set things right. The future promises the most intimate of relationships between me and our furry friends.
The dogs all sprung onto the table, stepping onto their plates and splattering everybody with food. Cruella cackled, but Chloe and Dipstick were appalled. Suddenly, Dipstick heard something. Fluffy was signaling the Dalmatian to follow him. Dipstick jumped down and followed Fluffy out of the dining room and down the stairs. Chloe soon noticed that Dipstick was missing and went looking for him. She found Fluffy and Dipstick standing in front of the portrait of the long-dead DeVille that hid the secret room. Fluffy hit the secret switch, and the portrait split in two and swung open. Dipstick jumped up and opened the door, and all three of them entered. Their eyes went immediately to an easel in the center of the room.
Dipstick, I can't believe that she...
Just then, they all heard the sound of distant barking. Dipstick pricked up his ears. The barking got closer. Oddball's message had reached Cruella's neighborhood. Dipstick's eyes widened as he got the news from his frantic family. He whirled around and ran out of the room. Fluffy scurried out after him. Chloe turned to follow them. Cruella appeared in the doorway, blocking Chloe's exit.
Surprise! Earlier than I'd planned, but Celavi.
I hereby revoke your probation.
And I hereby lock you up with St. Kevin of Assisi in the clink. It just wouldn't do if three more puppies were reported missing.
Three more?
Goodbye, my dear.
No!
I'll think of you every time I wear your sweet little doggies.
Cruella hurried out of the room,
no!
Slammed the door shut behind her, and locked it. Chloe was trapped. Meanwhile, Kevin and his animal friends were locked up in a jail cell. From outside, Waddlesworth heard the barking message of the Dalmatian puppies.
Oh! What? What is it?
Man grab with a wands, twee potted doggies.
Oh my gosh, Chloe's dogs.
Back at Chloe's flat, the Dalmatians were in deep trouble. LaPelt threw a sack over Dotty. Little Dipper and Domino were still barking at the front door. LaPelt grabbed them and threw them into the sack with Dotty.
Twee puppies, she said.
LaPelt grabbed Oddball from the window, silencing her alarm. Bruised and battered, LaPelt dropped her into the sack and headed out of the door. He didn't notice as a train ticket fell out of his torn pocket and fluttered to the floor. Outside, LaPelt threw the dog sack into the back of his truck and took off. Just as the truck pulled away, Dipstick ran up, exhausted. The barking from the departing truck caught his attention, and he raced heroically after it and just managed to leap onto the back of it as it rounded the corner. At the jail, Kevin and his animal friends were plotting a way to break out. Waddlesworth was small enough to walk out of the cell between the bars, so he crept down the hall and found the guard outside the cell block door. The guard was very sleepy, and Waddlesworth helped him along.
Go to sleep, go to sleep, go to sleep, little guardy.
The guard nodded off. Quick as a bird, Waddlesworth hopped onto the desk, snatched the cell keys, and they were free. Meanwhile, at the DeVille mansion, the dinner party was over. Fluffy watched secretly from an upstairs window as Cruella and Alonso got in her car and drove away. As soon as the coast was clear, Fluffy hit the secret switch to open the portrait of the long-dead DeVille and revealed the door to the secret room. He bounced up, clamped his jaws onto the key in the lock, unlocking it. Chloe was free. She raced home and ran up the stairs to her flat. She opened the door and saw the horrible mess LaPelt had left. But no dogs. Kevin ran up behind her, followed by Digger, Drooler, Chomp and Waddlesworth.
I'm so sorry. I should have trusted you.
No, I should never have trusted Cruella. And with my police record...
It doesn't matter.
Yes, it does matter. Look. I broke into the lab and freed those dogs. They were being used for experiments.
That was your dog-napping conviction?
Yes.
That's all?
Yes.
Chloe burst into tears and threw herself at Kevin, hugging him tight. The dogs were sniffing round, reading the clues of what had happened. They found the train ticket LaPelt had dropped. Chomp carried it over to Chloe and Kevin. Chloe examined it.
They're going to Paris! Come on!
They raced out, heading for the London train station. Meanwhile, Cruella and Alonso had just pulled up behind the station where they met LaPelt. LaPelt lifted the cover off the back of his truck and Dipstick flew out snarling, his teeth bared. But Cruella and LaPelt managed to load Dipstick and Dottie into a crate and set it on a baggage car. Cruella reached into the sack and pulled out Little Dipper and Domino. Then she lifted Oddball out of the sack. She peeled back Oddball's sweater to inspect her fur.
A rat! I need spotted puppies, you idiot!
She dropped Oddball, who scurried off.
Alonso!
Yes?
Find the rat, kill it. LaPelt and I will be on the Orient Express.
Kill?
The last time I underestimated a puppy, I wound up in the poke. Go!
Alonso chased after Oddball. Just as he was almost upon the spotless puppy, the baggage cart rolled by with the dog crate on it. But Oddball ducked under the rolling cart, and the cart ran over Alonzo's hands. He reeled back in great pain, and Oddball ran after the cart.
Last call for the Orient Express to Paris.
Alonzo had had enough. He headed off towards Platform 2, holding his mangled hands aloft. He found Cruella and LaPelt in the club car, drinking champagne.
You took care of the rat.
You will never see it again.
But Oddball was trotting beside the baggage car of the Orient Express, sniffing the air. She heard the dogs inside and frantically searched for a way to board the train. Then the train started to roll. Just then, Kevin, Chloe, and Kevin's animals ran into the station. They saw the Orient Express pulling out.
Oddball!
Oddball was running along the platform after the train, trying to jump onto the last car.
Don't jump!
Waddlesworth was very upset at the sight of his friend in trouble. He climbed onto Kevin's head and hopped off. He glided clumsily towards Oddball, but started falling.
Where did these come from? Blimey, they work! I can fly! Dogs can fly!
Waddlesworth grabbed Oddball by the scruff of the neck, lifted her off the ground, and flew with her through the rear door of the departing train. Puppy and Bird found themselves in the baggage car. Oddball raced over to the dog crate and was reunited with her family. Then she noticed that the dog crate was stored right next door to Cruella's car, which had also been loaded onto the train. Waddlesworth tried to understand.
Bad lady's cow? Oh, you're right. It is the bad lady's cow.
The Orient Express arrived in Paris the next morning. Cruella and LaPelt got into Cruella's car, not noticing Oddball and Waddlesworth in the back. Alonso loaded the dog crate onto a truck. Cruella drove off, leading the way through the streets of Paris, while Alonso followed behind in the truck. none of the people realized that the local French dogs were listening as the truck passed. Meanwhile, Kevin and Chloe had not given up the chase. They caught the next train to Paris with Kevin's dogs and arrived shortly after Cruella's caravan had pulled away. Digger, Drooler, and Chomp had heard of the Dalmatians' plight from the local French dogs and ran off in the direction of Cruella's caravan. Chloe and Kevin hopped into a taxi and followed after them. In a short while, they were able to find LaPelt's fur factory. They arrived in time to see Alonzo unloading his truck at the back of the factory. Chloe, Kevin, and Kevin's dogs hid as Alonzo opened an old coal hole cover and revealed a dank basement teeming with Dalmatian puppies. Alonzo dropped the Dalmatians into the basement, one at a time. He paused before dropping the last helpless puppy.
It's no good looking at me like that. It won't do any good, you know.
He sadly slid the final puppy down the chute. As soon as the coast was clear, Chloe, Kevin, Digger, Drooler, and Chomp ran to the basement door, opened it, and went inside, followed by the others. They were instantly mobbed by happy puppies and two adult Dalmatians.
Okay, let's get them out of here.
But before they could get even one puppy out, Cruella appeared at the basement door.
Aren't you in a tight spot?
Ooh, what fun to get away with murder. Ta-ta!
And she slammed the basement door and locked it.
There's got to be a way out of here.
Hello?
Waddlesworth poked his head down through a hole in the ceiling.
Waddlesworth, what's Oddball with you?
Oddball's nose poked through the hole. Chloe was so relieved she put up her hand so the puppy could lick it. Waddlesworth began gnawing the hole to make it larger. The old wooden floor was quite rotten. So in no time, the hole was sufficiently large enough to squeeze a puppy through. Kevin and Chloe began passing the puppies up one at a time. Oddball led the long line of puppies snaking across the factory floor to the foot of a flight of stairs and then directed them to run up one at a time. LaPelt's office was nearby, and he was busy laying out his horrible-looking skinning knives while Cruella and Alonzo watched. Suddenly, Cruella sensed something. She spun around in time to see a puppy heading up the stairs.
Ah, it's the little rat!
Cruella whirled on Alonzo.
You lied to me.
Me? What's your problem?
Does she look dead to you? Does she?
You worm! I'll kill her myself.
Alonzo finally had enough. He lunged at the pelt, and they tumbled out of the office and onto the factory floor. Alonzo broke free, and LaPelt chased after him. Alonzo grabbed a fur coat from the rack and slipped it backward onto LaPelt's arms, confusing the Frenchman. He then dived between LaPelt's legs. LaPelt turned and brought his foot up to stomp on Alonzo, but Alonzo rolled out of the way, and LaPelt's foot crashed right down through the hole in the floor. LaPelt struggled to pull his leg free, but the flooring gave way, and his other leg crashed through. LaPelt dropped through the now giant hole in the floor, the fur coat bunched up around his neck. He stuck fast with his legs dangling down into the cellar, where Kevin, Chloe, and the adult dogs were still trapped. Meanwhile, Cruella was in hot pursuit of Oddball and the rest of the puppies. She chased them onto a tiny, narrow bridge that connected the factory to the next-door building.
Here, puppy, puppy, puppy. Sweet puppy.
The building was an old industrial bakery filled with huge baking machines. The puppies were fleeing away on a walkway up near the ceiling. Cruella scrambled up the walkway. Oddball dashed away, and Cruella lost her balance. She grabbed onto a cable for support and swung off the walkway, dangling high above the bakery floor. The cable controlled the bakery's machinery, and it all came to life suddenly. Conveyor belts rolled, lights blinked, and the red glow of the huge fiery oven flickered everywhere. Back in the fur factory, Alonzo raced outside, unlocked the basement door, and freed Kevin, Chloe, and the dogs.
Quickly, upstairs! She's after the puppies!
They all charged into the factory, racing for the stairs. Meanwhile, Cruella had climbed down the cable onto a rolling conveyor belt. She grabbed at a lever for support, and a million eggs rained down upon her. She slipped down the egg-slicked belt and flipped into a big mixing vat. Oddball signaled the other puppies, and they pushed the buttons that made the giant mixing arms descend into the vat and knead the mixture, turning Cruella every which way as the goo thickened around her.
I've got you now, you little rat!
The huge blob of batter toppled onto a table. The blob quivered and wriggled as the crazed Cruella emerged and scanned the room for Oddball. She spotted the one spotless puppy and reached out a batter-slathered hand and snatched Oddball just as huge slicer blades descended in front of her.
Without spots, you're just not worth the trouble. Chop, chop!
And she tossed Oddball onto the slicer. All the puppies froze. Dipstick, Dotty, and Kevin's dogs were working their way downwards. They stopped, horrified, watching. Cruella grinned at the puppies.
Now to my coat!
Oddball popped up from between the blades, unharmed. Cruella was furious. She started towards Oddball again, when suddenly Waddlesworth swooped down at her face. The bird knocked the batter blob Cruella into a towering triple-decker wedding cake pan. The pan rolled down a conveyor belt right into the roaring oven. Everybody rejoiced. Soon, the Cruella cake was baked. It rolled out of the oven with Cruella's singed, smoking noggin sticking out of the top. The puppies romped along the counter as the cake passed, leaping on tubes that squirted frosting all over Cruella's face. The cake landed on a utility cart, and Chomp gave it a mighty shove. The cart thundered through the doors, out into the attached cafe, and right up to a big picture window where the Cruella cake was displayed for all the world to see. As the police came and hauled the giant confection away, Kevin and Chloe hugged each other, and all 102 Dalmatians danced joyfully around them. A few weeks later, Cruella's car pulled up to the Second Chance dog shelter.
Look out, everybody! It's the bad lady's cow!
The car door opened, but Alonzo stepped out, looking happy. He carried Fluffy in his arms. Fluffy stretched towards Chloe, who stroked her affectionately.
Hello, all. I've come from Mr. Ville's solicitor, Mr. Tort. I asked if I might have the pleasure of delivering this.
Alonzo handed Kevin a cheque.
£8 million.
Yes, it's the judge's orders. It's for the dogs, of course. And for the best, unless she's rehabilitated.
No, Alonso. Cruella will always be Cruella.
Well, hope springs eternal.
Alonso looked up and saw Oddball prancing on the roof.
What's that puppy doing up there?
Up where? No, Oddball!
Oddball!
Oddball slipped and dropped into Chloe's waiting arms.
Oh, Oddball!
Ah!
What have you been doing? Kevin, look. This one won't come off. She's got her spots. Oddball's got her spots! Look!
So Dotty and Dipstick, Digger and Drooler, Ewan and Waddlesworth, Kevin and Chloe, and everyone else crowded around to admire the happy puppies' long-awaited spots.